In this video, I'm going to be comparing the bloody A60 with the bloody A90. I've both of these mice myself and I've used them enough to know what the differences are. I'm going to be comparing them in CPS, PvP, bridging, size, weight and more. And I'm going to be saying which one of these is better for you, because there's not a better one, it just depends on what you like and what game modes you play, and I'm going to try and make your decision a lot easier. Maybe even both of these mice are nothing for you and you should look for something else. So first CPS, because that's probably why most people are here. As you can see, here's a clip of me bolt clicking on both mice. Bolt clicking is a clicking method that isn't really useful, but it does bring the mouse to its limit, and as you can see, these mice are both capable of registering every single click you can make. As you just saw, they can easily get over 150 CPS and are capable of way more. They have the same switches, so they can get the same CPS, and as you just saw, I even got a lucky 200 CPS on my A60. But there is one difference. For some reason, because of the way the mouse buttons are designed, or just the switches themselves, it is way easier to get an insanely consistent long drag with your bloody A60. I can consistently get a very high CPS. I also get a high CPS with the A90, but the drags aren't as long as the A60 and the clicks are less consistent. If you are someone that is going to do these long block clutches, the A60 will be the better option out of the two, as you will run out of space faster with the A90 and your clicks are less consistent. But for telebridging or reducing, they are both equal. So now the shape, the weight and the size. This is definitely the most important part. The shape of the A60 is just completely symmetrical, while the A90 has a slightly ergonomic shape. I personally like the shape of the A90 more, but it's all preference. Both mice are very heavy. On the bloody website, it says that the bloody A60 weighs 150 grams and the bloody A90 weighs 143 grams. You can feel the difference, but it's not that big, and I'ma be honest, for Minecraft the weight doesn't really matter, but if you're going to play other games, for example FPS games, I would not recommend these mice. Both mice are also very big, so I wouldn't really recommend these for people with small hands. So for bridging, it's mostly preference. They're both very good, but for me the A90 is easier to short drag because of the shape. Also, the back of the mouse where you have to hold it has a very grippy texture, which gives me more control over the mouse. While the A60 just has the same texture everywhere, which doesn't give you as much control over the mouse, but it is a decent texture for drag clicking. Also keep in mind that the A90 has like these grip things in the front that are terrible for drag clicking. So basically you are forced to use tape, which I personally don't mind, but it might be a problem for some people. While on the A60, as I said, the texture is good enough to drag, but for most people like myself, tape is still a better option. Also, one more thing, the mouse feet on the A90 and the A60 glide insanely well, but it's hard to keep the mouse still, so I put tape on my mouse feet to make it easier to control. You don't have to do this, but in my experience, it makes it easier. Okay, now for PvP. For single clicking and butterfly clicking, these mice are the same. You can stay consistently above 20 CPS with butterfly clicking if you double click, and both of their mouse buttons are wide enough to butterfly click on even if you have big hands. But for jitter click, the A90 is definitely the better option, as it has lighter switches. The A60 has heavier switches, which will make your jitter click less consistent. Also keep in mind that there are way better mice for PvP. I would only recommend these mice if you're also planning to drag click. So the availability is not the best for both mice. You can find them both on Amazon, but they are around $50, and for me I have to pay $20 for shipping. If shipping is free for you, I guess this is a decent deal, but you can also use the A60 waitlist on the bloody Instagram. The mouse should cost around $40, but you don't know when you will actually get the mouse and you might also have to pay a lot for shipping. The best place for me at the moment is on Newegg. There you can find the A90 for $32 and the A60 for $42 and no shipping fee. Maybe for you you have to pay shipping because it depends on where you live. I would not recommend paying for shipping, as there is probably a better option out there. If it's only like $5, maybe you could still buy it, but above above $10 for shipping is definitely not recommended. A good way is just looking up the mouse in Google where you can buy it, and maybe you can even find it in a store of your country without shipping. I would definitely not recommend paying more than $50 for one of these mice. So basically, you shouldn't buy these mice if you're into other games than Minecraft. Even if Minecraft is the only game you play, I wouldn't buy these if you aren't going to drag-click and only use them for PvP or something. If you have smaller sized hands, you should also not buy these mice. You should buy the A90 if you like the shape. If you're not really into extremely long block clutches, but you might want to try the God Bridge, Deli Bridge, and maybe even MLG Rush. You occasionally PvP to play Bed Wars or something, and you also have good drag-clicking tape to put on the mouse. You should buy the A60 if you're into this symmetrical shape, when you have big hands, and when you might want to try these long block clutches. You can bridge with it, but it's not the easiest to short drag, and you PvP with normal or butterfly click, and definitely not jitter click. Maybe you can drag without the tape, but definitely not everyone. So that is the end. Make sure to comment which one of these you want to buy, even if you can't buy it or if your parents won't let you. I want to know which one of these is the most popular. My personal favorite is the A90, as I don't really do these 40 block extensions, but I like the shape. I like bridging with it, like Daily Bridging and God Bridging, and I also play a decent amount of MLG Rush. If you made it here, make sure to subscribe, and I hope I can see y'all in the next video. Goodbye.